Here we go. Hello, all you turkey junkies out there. It is your host with the most, Benjamin Dutil, with the Horror Heathen YouTube channel and the South Jersey Horror Podcast. Today, I have a very special guest, Karen Cliche, who you all know plays Kathleen in the movie Thanksgiving, who just came out in theaters November 17th, directed by Eli Roth, which is an outstanding movie. Just finished watching it today, and I am super happy with it. I think Eli Roth just elevated his status as a director. He is now, in my opinion, now up there with Quentin Tarantino. So, enough about Eli Roth. My guest today is Karen Cliche, who plays Catherine. And thank you so much for joining me today. I really do appreciate you. Welcome to my show.
Thanks for having me.
It is such a huge honor and a pleasure. The pleasure is all mine. I loved it. I loved you in the movie. You did such a great role. Your acting as the stepmother is phenomenal. I loved it.
It's weird. I always get cast at these as these roles. It must be my face or something. I don't know.
But you weren't a wicked stepmother, which is good. You're a good stepmother. I mean,
yeah. I mean, that's up for interpretation. But I think that I didn't want her to come across. She's not the villain in the movie, but she's just a little out there, so to speak. So, yeah.
So, if you don't mind providing a brief background for the audience, please.
So I was born French. I'm French Canadian, and I've been acting for about 25 years. Started when I was, just kind of modeling at the same time. I was in university studying psychology as well, and it was always a dream of mine to act. So once I got the opportunity to start auditioning, it just kind of took off from there. So I did a bunch of TV series, mostly sci-fi based action roles. That was super fun. And then I took a bunch of years off to have my daughter and focus on that, and came back in the game officially, like full on, a couple years ago. So this has been a nice re-entry into the game with this movie for sure. It's so fun.
There's no better way to come back in than with the Eli Roth movie.
It's like a gift I had to just unwrap. Thank you.
Yeah. So I did do some digging around on you, and in 2007, you were nominated for Best Ensemble Performance in the Comedy Program or Series for The Business. I don't know if you knew about that or not.
Yeah, that was great. That was a comedy. That was a thing that we just did 6 episodes. It had a pretty general script, but we were allowed to improvise like crazy. And that's a kind of a specialty of mine. I love it. I know I'm not known for comedy, but I do a lot of comedy. And so that was super fun. That was magical. Just every scene just being different. And it was such a great cast, hilarious, dirty. I played a porn star. And so just the jokes were endless. The dirty jokes that are in my mind 24/7 got to come out to play safely, so I was in heaven.
As long as everyone enjoyed the roles, there's nothing to complain about. I mean, screw it, right? I mean,
yeah.
So, for those who have not seen Thanksgiving yet, it's a great movie, and the premise of the movie is after a Black Friday riot ends in tragedy, a mysterious Thanksgiving inspired killer terrorizes a small town, Plymouth. I love a small town. Looks small in the movie, Plymouth, Massachusetts, and the birthplace of the infamous holiday. So, John Carver, I can't believe that the killer inspired himself after the John Carver, and to be called John Carver in the news. I was like, that's, I don't know. I mean,
the last name kind of suits what happens to everybody, right? Carver, carved up, is a little play on words, I think. I don't know if anyone realized that, but he's the masked, he or she, I should say. He or she is the masked killer. Exactly. Spoiler. It's so much fun. And I think being in a small town, things taking place in a small town always makes for better plots because of the closeness of people. Everyone knows each other, and then everyone's kind of suspicious of each other. And yeah, it was just really a nice format for that. Nice setting.
It was done so well. It was from Ontario, right? Canada, I think it was filmed at, in Ontario?
In and around Toronto, yes. Toronto, Canada.
Okay. So, acting in horror movies is nothing new for you. You were in Saw 6, Abducted on Prom Night, Deadly Estate, and Galentine's Day Nightmare. So acting.
See, that's
I'm
five
sorry.
times that.
I'm tongue tied today. I was telling Amber I had to rush home from work, so in order to be here on time to interview you. So so acting in the movie Thanksgiving, was it a change of pace for you, or was it the same?
Well, it was definitely different. I mean, the other ones were more like thrillers, Saw 6 excluded. Saw 6 was definitely gory and horror. What I liked about Thanksgiving is that it had kind of more like all the elements. It really was kind of this well-rounded script of, it had some fun in it. It had some normal scenes. It had mystery in it. It was campy a little bit. It was jump scares, terrifying. So I feel like everybody I've talked to, like of all ages, have seen this movie and are like, pleasantly surprised, because I thought it was going in, it was going to be such a niche thing. It was going to be like adored and loved by just horror fans, you know, the sickos out there who watch this stuff. But no, it seems like people are just going, that was fun. That wasn't as bad as I thought. So, So I was kind of used to it, like edgy stuff. And of course, Saw 6 being on that carousel and having everybody's brains blown out on my face was just another day at work. But this was different because of that crazy intense scene that I shot, that took all day, the scene in the oven. That was really intense. That was definitely the longest horror scene, really just kind of featuring me, that I've ever shot. So that took everything out of me. It was an incredible opportunity as an actor to just dive in so deep. And lose my voice and get bruised up. And it was just, loved it.
I love it. That's great. That was actually get more into that later on in an interview. So in the acclaimed movie, you play Kathleen, which seems to be a very tense role in a sense. The new wife to Thomas, the stepmother to Jessica, who keeps prying Thomas to open the store on Black Friday. Do you think that was the catalyst of creating all the mayhem and the killing?
Are you saying that was all my fault? Listen, Kathleen had expensive tastes. Okay. She needed to have the money come in so she could, you know, redecorate that big mansion that she loved living in. So definitely, if you see that there's a theme in the movie, that people that were a little bit more on the greedy side and, you know, lost the true meaning of Thanksgiving, kind of got it. So, you know, yes, I'm sure that her attitude about reopening the store was responsible for her fate.
Well, part of my friends, but shit happens, okay, on Black Friday, just saying.
It certainly did. Yeah.
So the death scenes, I love the death scenes in the movie. I have two favorite death scenes. One, yours is one of them, obviously. But, The first kill in the dumpster, I was like, oh my god, that had to be the not the most brutal one, but the most gory one. I mean,
yeah,
just I'm watching this, like, she hit by the quantum jumps. I'm like, oh shit, that was like, that was my exact reaction. I mean, I was like, that was never, I was not expect that to happen, because you see her running and then, but then you see her dive in the dumpster, but you think, okay, she's gonna be safe in the dumpster, but no, half her body is cut in half and shit just starts pouring out.
Yeah, it's like you'll never eat sausages again the same way. Honestly, when I looked at that, I was like, this looks like just linked to sausages. Gross. Yeah, well, that's Eli's brain for you. What can I say? You know, he just wanted to take it over the edge. And then even when he talked about the scene with me, because we actually shot that separately. That was months later. That was a brainchild of his. Originally, it was just revealed that I was what happened to me on the table. So we actually shot the whole oven scene and the chase scene and the John Carver stuff separately, like back in August, actually. So when he called me and discussed that idea that he had, I was like, what? Oh my God. Of course I was like, yeah, let's do it. But I was like, this is sick. This is just insane. So yeah, that was really such an honor to be asked to do that, to be put in that position. So that was, that was a secondary thought, actually, like a little added stuff to the movie, which I think really, really did make my role a little bit more interesting and a little crazier, and just added to the insanity of the film, actually.
I believe firmly that you suffered the most or the worst fate in the movie, being cooked in the oven live. It was just, to me, I was
torture.
thinking this is gonna
Torture. It was pure torture.
Yeah.
God. Yeah.
Of course, there were some challenges. Can you discuss the challenges about doing that role, like physically, mentally? What did you have to do to prepare yourself for that role or for that scene? I'm sorry.
Well, I knew that because I do voice work on the side, that I do a lot of radio, TV, and web commercials. So I know my voice. I know what can happen to your voice when you scream too much. So I had on hand, of course, like all the hot water and lemon and all the lozenges, because I just knew that eventually I was going to lose my voice, right? Because it was 10 hours of shooting on and off. And I was tied up. I was on a metal grate. There was no comfort involved. There was no, let's fake this. It was all real. Like thank God I wasn't claustrophobic. I was locked in. I was on steel grates. I was banging around. So I was like black and blue and everything. And so by the end of the day, I was losing my voice. And so I had to tell Eli, when he wanted to, there's more shots to do. And I said, we got to start narrowing it down. Like, tell me, like, I got one or two more takes in me. So let's just save it. If you got this crazy idea for a close-up, I'm going to save it for that. So we had to kind of strategize, because I didn't want to end and not even be able to scream. Yes, I could have done it in ADR after. You can do it in studio, but it's never as good. Like, it's never as intense. So yeah, so we just worked together, and he was so amazing. And it was a real collaborative effort. And he was really, really supportive throughout the whole process. So that was definitely physically challenging, my voice. I mean, I couldn't really speak for a couple of days after. And then the bruises, I don't mind. I'm a tough girl. I can deal with that. But just like being dragged on the grass, and I couldn't get that dirt out of my fingernails for about 5 days. There were some physical challenges and emotional and everything. But I love that. It's kind of a role that actors die for. Pun intended. It was, we want to be pushed to that limit. We don't just want to phone it in, because once you have, I have 25 years experience. I'm not saying anything other than sometimes you you can kind of phone it. You can do it. It's easier, depending on the role. But then when you get faced with a challenge like this, it's like, yes, this is what I was here for. This is what I'm here to do. So I was really happy about that. To get the chance to do that.
We did it so well. I mean, kudos on you for doing that kind of scene, because it was. I would not want to see anyone in real life to come to that kind of fate in their life like that. That it sucks. So, I don't know if you. Have you ever seen? Have you ever watched the Hostel movies?
Yeah.
At all?
Yeah, a few times. Okay. And it's before I even got this. Hostel was one of the horror movies that I watched the most, probably.
So, his name is Richard Hoffman, the guy who plays your husband in the movie. I think it's Richard Hoffman. He was in one of the Hostel movies.
Yes.
And that scene right there where he carves the piece of meat off, that is paying homage to the Hostel movie. I picked it up right away. I was like, holy shit.
Yeah. Well, him and Eli are friends, right? So, Eli had such a hoot, a really fun time with him on set, because Rick is so funny. Rick is funny without even knowing that he's funny sometimes. That's the deal. So that was just great. He had so many great bloopers and outtakes. And I don't know, everybody listening should, when you see the movie, make sure you stay till after the credits, because there's a little nugget with Rick at the end of the movie. So the very end.
I have to go back because that's the only sad part about watching, getting early access on links, is like, I don't get the chance to watch the credits, this in credits. So right. It just stops right at the end of the movie. So I'm about to Google it or something like that to watch it on Google or YouTube or something. So so the chemistry on set, I'm assuming it was really well, because you have Eli Roth, you have Rick Hoffman, all these young actors and actresses. Were you able to provide them any guidance or any advice on how to, in acting at all? Because you're a seasoned actor. I mean, you had to give them some pointers, right?
Share my wisdom. You know what? They were so great. They were so great. I didn't have a lot of scenes with the youngins. It was mostly me and Rick and Patrick. But we definitely, intertwined on set a lot of the times. And, they were just all so humble and sweet. Even Addison, who's, got this major career, she's got a lot of notoriety. She was sweet as can be. I had really good talks with Jalen, actually, who played Bobby. Yes. Hold on, I'm kidding. Hold on, I can't. The baseball player. I'm having a blank here. Yes. Jalen was great. He was really, really sweet. So humble beyond belief. And like we had a lot of talks about how to navigate the industry, how to stay humble and sane throughout all this. So yeah, I would definitely say I had some really nice deep conversations with him. Milo is really experienced, but the chemistry overall was incredible. I couldn't have asked for a better cast, crew, director. Jeff, who's the co-writer with Eli as well, super funny. It was the best time, I have to say. I know a lot of people say that about a project, but for me, it was really, really like goes down in history as one of the overall best crews cast ever that I've worked with.
It had to be because, like I said, even on camera, the chemistry seemed like it was going so well with everybody. And totally. I didn't pick up any attention from anyone watching it on camera. So, which I thought was really cool. I can imagine working with Eli Roth. He's like one of the coolest and laid back one of directors I've ever seen.
Yeah, exactly. He set the tone.
Well, except for his role in Inglourious Basterds. That's a whole different thing.
But that's what's so great about him. He's an actor, right? So he knows how to talk to us. He knows what we're going through. He knows how to, he's in the trenches with us. So that makes such a huge difference than just being kind of like told what to do by a director who doesn't know how to act. It was amazing in that way.
So going back to special effects and the makeup. See, I'm still tongue-tied after just a few minutes talking to you.
You're drunk. It's Friday.
It is Friday.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
So going back to the special effects, the makeup, and the dialogue, what is your take on all that happened in the movie?
Well, the special effects was super fun. So it was me, Tommaso, and somebody else, maybe Tim Dillon. I think he had a head prosthetic. So we all went to LA back in February to get our prosthetics or our heads done by, they won an Oscar for The Whale. So they were amazing. Adrian. So that was, we were with the highest quality people, amazing, amazing, talented special effects people that did that. And then the other stuff like my burns and everything, got that done by a company in Toronto. So that was just fun. I mean, I spent 2 hours getting all that on me and then 2 hours getting it off. But that just really adds, you know, it just, when, you know, we have an imagination as actors, we can totally do that, but it really helps when your body is physically resembling what is happening. So that just helped me get into the role 100%. I was not there when they filmed the final dinner scene, but I saw pictures the next day on set. They're like, look, Karen, look what we shot yesterday. I was like, oh my God, that's me.
Turkey, no.
Oh my God. Like in the separate and the legs and the, anyway, so it was pretty, pretty cool.
Definitely an interesting scene. And I'm just like, I felt sorry for your character being killed like that. I mean, others had, ill-fated death scenes, but yours, I felt sympathy for you because I was like, God, that really sucks.
It really did. And you know, there's some people on set, like some of the crew walked off when I was filming it. They walked out. They were like, that's too hard to watch. I don't know if it's because they knew me personally at this point. But I mean, that's really good. I'm really happy that people are feeling that because that means I did my job as an actor. You know, I made you feel something. I'm happy that you were sad for me for dying. Anyway, you know what I'm saying?
Sorry, that sucks. They're like, no, but anyway. So, I don't know how much of a horror fan you are. Are you familiar with John Carpenter's Halloween from 1978?
Maybe not the 78 one, but I did work with Rick Rosenthal, who I believe directed one of the Halloweens, maybe the first or second one, actually. Yeah, he's a good friend of mine.
So, in the beginning of Thanksgiving, you hear the heavy breathing of the person. Like, that is the exact same opening in Halloween from 1978.
Okay.
So. Yeah, I was like, because as you can tell behind me, I'm a huge Halloween fan. So Michael Myers is my dude. So.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Yes, I see that knife that you have there. Oh, my God. Wow. Okay.
My whole wall behind me is all Michael Myers. So.
Love it. Love it. What's your t-shirt?
Oh, it's Friday the 13th as Jason
Oh, okay.
Voorhees, because, you know, yeah.
Yeah. I grew up on those.
Who didn't? I mean, it's they're classics. And I actually went to the camp where the movie was filmed, not too long ago. Yeah,
Wow.
it was actually the Friday the 13th weekend, but I went on a Saturday instead of Friday because all tickets were sold out on Friday. So I went the next day. So it was still cool to see it at nighttime to take the whole tour and everything like that, which is really cool to plan to watch. It was a
Amazing.
3-hour tour. I loved it.
Cool.
So are there any other projects, any exciting projects, movies coming up you could talk about that the audience can look forward to seeing?
Well, as you know, we just got out of a strike, so a very long strike. So things were quite slow and not really moving into production. But now things, I hope we're going to start up. Obviously, it's the holidays coming up. So in January, I hope to have some projects booked. But I did shoot a comedy a couple months ago in Toronto called Race Walkers. That'll be coming out next year. And then I'm gonna start appearing at some horror cons. I have a couple booked already, so I look forward to meeting fans and having some fun there. So stay tuned for that. You know, I'm on Instagram. I'll be announcing all my appearances there. So yeah, that's what I have planned for most of next year for now.
You gotta come to Monster Mania. It's one of the biggest conventions on the East Coast, the
Which one?
Northeast. Monster Mania.
Okay, yeah. Yes, I've heard of that. Yeah, I think we're gonna work on
No.
that.
Because I would love to see. I always talk to people who I interviewed at the conventions, and it's always cool to see the people that I've interviewed. Like, I've ever seen Terrifier 2 with the little pale girl, the clown girl. She instantly recognized me when I walked up to get an autograph. She's like, "Oh my
Oh.
God, it's Dan!" She's like, "Finally good to see you after 3 years, you know?" It's like,
Yeah. Fun. It's like a little family. I love talking to fans. I mean, yeah, there's some I've known for 25 years, and this is very special to me. I love it.
So, to go along the whole Thanksgiving thing, and it might be a little late to ask you this, but speaking of Thanksgiving and being thankful, what are you thankful for this year?
Oh gosh. Well, I went through a lot of changes this year. So I am very grateful for, you know, kind of taking risks and taking chances and following my instincts and following my heart and really pursuing my who I truly am now at this point in my life. So I made a lot of changes that have all turned out to be the right decision. So I'm really happy now. I'm happier than I've been in a long time. So that I'm super grateful for. Proud of myself for making those changes. They were not easy. But yeah, I mean, it sounds really cheesy, but as we get older, we're just like, wow, I'm so grateful that I'm healthy. I work out almost every day. I'm happy to do what I do for a living. I'm happy for the ups and downs. I'm just really grateful for everything. Friends, like it sounds really like not fake, but it's true. Like I really am in a really good space in my life. I have a wonderful daughter and two beautiful cats, and I'm really in a very happy phase right now. So yeah, let's hope it continues.
Well, I certainly hope that it does continue for you because it looks like you're doing so well for yourself. And I wish you nothing but the best in your career. And I want to see you get an award for this movie. I really do. Because
Aww.
you suffered the worst death in the movie. I'm sorry. It's just,
Yeah.
you just played Kathleen so well. I want to see you're Oscar worthy. God damn it. If no one disagrees with me, they can just.
I did not hear that. But thank you. Feel free to spread the word. That'd be fun.
Definitely will.
But thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the lovely, the beautiful, the talented Karen Cliche, thank you so much for joining me today. It's been an absolute pleasure and an honor speaking to you about your role on Thanksgiving. And I will see you in more movies.
Thank you so much for having me. That was fun.
All right, take care.